There's Your Trouble. That's a band called the Dixie Chicks. It's now coming up to 11 minutes to 12 o'clock. I like Girl, but did you see the cars on Glastonbury on television the other night? They were absolutely fantastic and how they looked. And you said to yourself, little girls from Ireland, I'm glad I'm from here. And it says here, welcome home, Elsie, from your holidays. Please play Daniel O'Donnell's new record. That's from Nora. Well, there's no need for that. Hello to Caroline in Twinbrook. That's from Francis. Also, hello to Maria. Keep mushrooming, it says, from the Maverick. That sounds vaguely lewd. For Brian, it says, please play The Stone Outside Dan Murphy's Door. And also, please wish a very happy birthday to Anne McCann of Cave Hill Road in Belfast from the Bradley family. If possible, please play The Chieftains with the Rankin family. P.S. Anne was a winner on your rickety wheel. The rickety wheel seems so long ago, seems so far away. I've got a nice book here. It was sent to me by a man called Roddy Andrews, who wrote a lovely little book called Requiem for a Village. It's a history of the village of Monkstown. I'm having a look through that. It looks very interesting indeed. I read a couple of little, I read one chapter actually this morning. It's very good. And he says, you can't buy it publicly, well, you can't buy it in bookshops, but he says you can buy it in the address that is given in the leaflet that is enclosed. Well, I haven't got the leaflet that's enclosed. I'm going to have a wee look at that. And I'll tell you more about that tomorrow. And if you can send me some details of where you can buy this, Roddy, I'm sure people would be interested in this. Lovely, very well produced little book. I wish I'd wrote a book like this. Eh? Looks really hardback and everything. Requiem for a Village, a history of the village of Monkstown. Roddy Andrews, what?
Where is Monkstown?
Hold on a minute.
No, you're looking at the map. I couldn't take you to Monkstown. I really couldn't.
There's a map here.
Yeah.
It's...
You don't know either.
It's not terribly far from Duck.
We don't know where Monkstown is.
I don't know where Duck is either.
No, I don't know.
I don't know where Monkstown is.
No.
I should know. I know. Look, you upset me now. Look, it's on the railway line between Belfast and London.
On the railway line. On the railway line.
It's a stop on the before they were closed. I don't know where Monkstown.
Callum McGarvey wants you.
All right then. Hello, good morning, Kathleen.
Good morning, Gerry.
Happy birthday to you.
It's not my birthday.
Hold on a minute.
Who told you it was my birthday?
Hold on a minute. I have a request.
It's not my birthday, but I like Doris Day.
Hold on a minute. I have a thing here for you. It's a request for your birthday.
Well, it's not my birthday. My birthday's not until September.
Is it not?
No.
This is a terrible mistake on my part.
Well, it's all right. It'll make me feel older now because of two birthdays in the 1 year.
I apologise because this will be very bad for you because people will be ringing up and saying they forgot about your birthday and stuff like that. Well, who is this request for? Hold on a minute. Oh, Kathleen McGarry.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought it was McGarvey.
Well, there's another. You see, I know a lady called Kathleen.
I turned to my
Edgar
there, didn't I? What? Sorry? Sorry,
Kathleen. I know a lady called Kathleen McGarvey, but she doesn't live in Ballymena.
No, obviously not.
And she's far more sensible than me.
Uh-huh. But anyway, it's prudent. And
well,
indeed,
I want to sing you a wee song.
Yes. Well, that's what we wanted. We were hoping that you would ring. You see, people have been asking me to play the song that's been written about me by Seamus Martin, but I can't do that.
Uh-huh.
So a man rang up and he was castigating me for my failure to do so.
Uh-huh.
And mentioned the fact that you had indeed written the best song about
yes,
me.
Yes, but that's the one about I Belong to Gerry.
That's what he was talking about, Jess.
Uh-huh. Well, he has that one. What about the one about his name is Gerry Anderson from the East Rope, London D?
That sounds a bit of a mouthful, really, doesn't it? Have you written one called that?
Sure, I sung it on your TV programme.
That's right, but it just seems so long ago.
Yes, well, I still remember it.
Well, I do remember it too, but I just can't remember. I can't remember the air or indeed the content of the lyrics.
Yes.
Well, would you care to perform that again?
Well,
maybe?
I'll perform it again for you if I can remember it.
Have you got your banjo handy?
Yes, I have it in my hand.
Give her a bit of a plunk there.
Okay. Just hold on now.
It's all right. But I need to hear it plonking. That's not it. I need to hear it plonking before it makes me feel any better. That's it. I feel better already.
His name is Gerry Anderson from the East Rope, London D. He talks a lot of balderdash, well, near as much as me.
Thank you.
Some people think he's cheeky, and others think he's daft. But me, I just...
enjoy him, for he always makes me laugh. He has a band of helpers that man the telephone, and if you have a viewpoint, you can always make it known. So when you're feeling lonely, or you want your blood to boil, call on to Gerry and his friends. They're there at Radio
Foyle. That's a cracker. That's a cracker. I like that one, Kathleen.
Do you like that
one? I do.
One?
I remember it now perfectly.
Uh-huh.
That's good. No, that I prefer that one.
You like that one the best.
I do, but, you know, modesty forbids me from talking about it any further.
Uh-huh.
I just like it because it's got a nice lilt to it.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
What's that melody? What is that? Johnson's Motor Car. Is
no,
it?
It's Paddy McGinty's goat.
Is it Paddy McGinty's goat?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Percy French.
Well, then I have another wee one here. It's not very long.
Did Percy French write that?
No, he didn't.
Well, what's the other one then?
Well, this is just the one that I wrote myself.
Yes.
Hold on.
That's okay. No, it's all right. Yes.
I don't want to go to the party. There'll be nobody there that I know. There'll be nothing but drink. At least that's what I think. And I'm really reluctant to go. Then a still small voice says, you're invited. That's a good enough reason for going. Tis a context you have, you must fight it, or you'll just be left sitting alone. Now I hurry to put on my glad rag, take my banjo and sit at the back. I am just an old-time entertainer, of my music they'll never keep track. Let me tell you, I went to the party. It shows you how wrong you can be. I had a great night. There was nobody tight. And the last one to leave, it was me.
That's a relief. That's a good one.
Is that all right?
That's a good one. I think you're ready to put an album out.
Oh, Gerry, wait till I tell you. I can do this sitting here in my chair. With my dog sitting up behind me, but I'm not really. It's a case of now have banjo but don't want to travel.
Have banjo, unwilling to travel.
Yeah.
Okay, Kathleen, thank you very much.
All right.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Sorry it's not your birthday.
Oh, well, listen, when it is my birthday, I'll let you know.
Okay.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye.